I'm Milk and this is Milk Astrology. Welcome to my channel, or welcome back to my channel. For those of you who don't know me, I am an astrologer and tarot reader, and I want to be a YouTuber, but that's literally up to you guys, so feel free to, you know, let that happen. Today I'm going to be going over Saturn in the houses and kind of how that, or what that means for you, because I feel like for some reason a lot of people don't really talk about Saturn, or I feel like we just don't really have a clear understanding of Saturn. So I felt like what better way to teach you guys than by like dragging you based on where Saturn is in your chart? Let's do that. And then also I'm doing a video with my dog because I think if you guys have been following my Twitter, he did start heart failure medication. He is very old and I'm not gonna cry while I film this. So he's a sleepy boy. He's still healthy. He's still eating and stuff. So I just want to keep him near me at all times. Although, like, if you look at my old videos, he's always kind of near me anyway. So yeah, he's just came to say hello to you guys. Let's get into the video. What is Saturn? Saturn is this planet that is like the disciplinary father figure. It is the kind of like, it's this planet that knows you can do better. So it kind of puts you through a lot of tasks and a lot of like hoops because it knows that you're able to supersede the expectations of it. However, because of that, it can feel very pressuring. It's basically like someone tossing a bunch of work at you and saying, I know you can do it, and then just expecting you to do it. Doesn't mean that it's the most comfortable. So Saturn is this like tough disciplinarian father figure. It knows that we can do better, so it piles on a lot for us to do. And I think even though it is challenging and there are a lot of themes surrounding like taking on more responsibility and rising to the occasion, we can often feel really just good about ourselves and accomplished after we kind of meet the standards that we're being forced to meet. But it's also like unnecessary tension at times. When we think of where Saturn is in our chart and what that means to us, or how that kind of depicts anything about us, it's going to be where we take ourselves the most seriously. It's going to be what we really prioritize and obligate ourselves to, but it could also be where we feel a little bit of maybe even suspicion, where we find ourselves straying away or being so careful about this area of our life that we can sometimes miss out on opportunities. Have Saturn in the first house, you take yourself very seriously. Arguably though, you were probably maybe bullied in school growing up, and you probably went through very huge devastations in the sense that you always had to prove yourself or you always had to explain yourself. And I think because of this, you are now incredibly focused on trying to always make sure that you put your best foot forward. Like, you don't want to give anyone anything to use against you. So I think you're very hyper aware of yourself for this reason. However, I do think that with this placement, you could also be so hypercritical of yourself that you're always overthinking, even more so than other people around you even notice. So you'll be like monitoring something that you said or did when other people around you didn't even register in their head that it happened. So obviously your biggest goal in this lifetime is to be a little easier on yourself. I do think there is maybe some things that took place earlier on in life that you might need to heal from, and that could be why it's harder for you. I do think that you might also be very fiercely independent and don't like to ask for help. I feel like maybe people very early on in life might have held things over your head or made you feel some sort of way, and because of these reasons you might be very critical or careful not to give anyone ammunition over you to be able to say that they helped you. And I feel like there is some kind of taboo at times with relationship dynamics for this reason. However, again, this isn't to say that you can't ever trust anyone or that you are always gonna do things on your own. It's just really about learning like how to lower your guard and how to discern who is and isn't worth your time. Saturn in the second house, I do feel like maybe growing up, you might have seen people be very careless with money, and because of this, you're very meticulous with it. I don't really think you're materialistic, but I do think you're consumed by the need to always like have means and be able to take care of yourself and maybe your loved ones. However, you can really let a lot of opportunities pass you by because you're always so careful of like saving. And I think the biggest lesson for you is learning to live in the moment versus always preparing for what happens tomorrow. Granted, I do understand why it is this way, because you did go through so much just to kind of be able to save. And Saturn in the second, people might have struggled with maybe distrust financially at an early age. Maybe they had family members that just weren't always responsible with their money, and because of this, they don't really like to ask for money and they're very suspicious about like business pursuits or financial pursuits in general. I do think that they put a lot of trust or placement of importance into what they invest in, whether this is relationships or financial issues. So if situations go wrong for them or they just don't go the way that they wanted them to, it can be a lot more detrimental to how they feel about themselves. I think obviously they need to learn to take themselves less seriously. I think like allowing themselves to spend more and not be so strung up in the idea of saving for a day that they don't even know if they're going to be around for. Like it's just, they need to be more present in the moment. So Saturn in the third house, this is a person that takes their communication and the things that they say very seriously. I feel like maybe earlier on in life, things that they might have said were used against them. And I feel like because of this, they're very hypercritical and aware of like what they say before they say it. I think the fastest way to maybe offend them or to get on their bad side is to basically maybe misquote them. I think the most important thing for them is to always say things that they 100% stand by. So I feel like they have a hard time understanding people who maybe speak very freely and maybe without as much importance in their words as maybe the Saturn in third house person often puts themselves. Also, a Saturn in third house person is not going to say that they feel some kind of way or care about you if they really don't, and they just probably hope or ask that you extend the same kind of honesty to them. I think they really hate people who just say anything without really meaning it, and they always make a point of really overly being aware of what they say before they say it. However, I do think that this overcalculation can sometimes keep them from even speaking their truth or being honest with themselves, and that could also be something that hinders them at times. Saturn in fourth house is someone that is very prioritizing or obligatory of their home and the people in it. So if they decide to invest in you, they are planning to invest in you until death. They are not planning to, you know, change their mind or reinvest in someone different. They are very dedicated to kind of being faithful to the obligations and commitments that they say they're going to be obligated to. I think maybe early on in life, they might have had a family dynamic where people weren't always as prioritizing of them as they were of others. And I think because of this, they're now very prioritizing of the commitments that they make because of this. However, they're also incredibly careful with who they prioritize because of these dynamics, because of this maybe sense of abandonment at an early age. They could be very critical. However, this isn't to say that they are immune to these connections or bonds. I do think that they're very caring and very, how do I say, very loyal to the commitments that they make when they decide to make them. I think it's just the getting there, it can be a bit tricky at times. Saturn in the fifth house is someone that denies themselves a lot of pleasure, doesn't really like to treat themselves, feels guilty when they buy themselves things. And I think this stems from the fact that maybe growing up, they might have seen a parent who did a lot of things excessively, was a little bit more of like a child than a parent. And I think that the Saturn in fifth house person had to be more of a parent than a child. So I feel like now when there are like things that they want to do for themselves or things they want to buy, I feel like there is a little bit of guilt there. I do think they need to work on or improve on not being so focused on what's responsible of them or what's needed of them that they forget to just like enjoy themselves and enjoy life in general and do things for themselves. It's like almost like they work so hard where they don't ever want to like enjoy the benefit of, you know, like the pay of working so hard, that kind of thing. People with Saturn in the fifth house, when they are married or when they have children or when they commit to anything in life, they are going to see it through. They're going to be the ultimate wifey partner kind of person. They're really going to just be the most loyal to you and to the commitments that they have within their like direct home and their environment. Saturn in the sixth house, they take their career and their jobs very seriously, but they also take their structure and routine very seriously. Again, this could have also stemmed from maybe a lack of structure growing up, and I think because of this reason, they could also be workaholics. There might be themes within Saturn in 10th house and Saturn in sixth house growing up maybe poor, and I think because of this, they're very kind of focused around always needing to work, always needing to have money, always needing to like have these kinds of commitments that they uphold. I think their biggest fear is like if their daily routine gets kind of off off track because there is this like uncertainty that makes them feel like things are going out of control. Saturn and sixth house, I mean, they're going to be the strongest workers. They're going to be the most successful, the most driven. But I do think like finding balance between rest and work is one of the biggest focal points for them. Saturn in 7th house. Saturn in 7th house is very prioritizing of their commitment, their intimacy, their relationship dynamics, but they're also very closed off and sheltered. They don't really like to get too close to anyone. I think this stems from the fact that growing up they might have had abandonment issues, or I think people were always just like very unreliable for them. And I think because of this, they're very closed off. But I think it also stems from the fact that they just really don't want to get hurt. They really don't want to get their, you know, feelings kind of stomped on. And I feel like there is kind of a repetitive issue with the fact that this has happened to them a lot. However, I think it's really important that Saturn in seventh house people really try to open up more and get close to the people around them that they care about, because I do think that they are very resilient people and people that are, they really have a lot to give. They're like arguably one of the most loyal Saturn placements in the houses. However, I just think that they can be very suspicious of people, and I think this can sabotage them sometimes. Saturn in the 8th house. If you have Saturn in the 8th house, you are someone that might have seen a parent or a loved one go through some kind of debt situations at an early age. I think because of this, you're very cautious. I think you're very careful not to allow yourself to ever owe anyone anything or be in any kind of debt. I think you're very careful with the fact that, you know, you want to be someone that really just is always very responsible. I would say even that, like, growing up when you first were able to get a credit card, you probably didn't want to. And I think this is just like a lot of the stigma and suspicion around like debt and owing anyone anything in general. You might also really like to like hate asking for help or hate letting anyone buy you anything or do anything for you. And I think that this can really come off cold. And I don't think that you mean to do this or that you mean for it to come off this way. I just think that you can struggle with the fact that people aren't, you're just very suspicious of someone holding anything over your head. And I think, unfortunately, I think people don't really understand where that comes from. However, I think your biggest lesson in life is learning that not everyone is out to get you, and that there are worse things in life. Like, I feel like by the overt need to always be in control of your finances, you're still kind of putting your life or revolving it in some way around finances, which is just as draining as if you were to be in debt. I mean, clearly not as much, but you know what I mean. Saturn in the 9th house, these people maybe grew up questioning their intelligence a lot. I feel like people are very quick to knock you down or to make you feel small sometimes with your perspectives and your theories on life. Maybe just like people around you didn't think as uniquely as you did. And because of this, you've spent a lot of time educating yourself, learning about the things that matter to you. And I think because of this, you're also very protective of that. You're very protective of your knowledge. So when someone tries to knock it down or disprove you or make you feel like you're wrong, I really do feel like that hurts you, because it's kind of like this really strong sense of, you know, I think it triggers like a sense of the rejection that you went through in childhood of people making you feel small intellectually, when I feel like the people, I feel like this is kind of a really sad placement, because people that have this placement question themselves a lot when they're actually really intelligent. Like, really intelligent people question themselves a lot, and really unintelligent people never question themselves ever. So that's something that I just personally feel. I think the best way to just like alleviate some of this tension is just like the more you read, the more you take time to learn things that you care about, putting your energy and focus on just like enhancing your knowledge can feel like kind of soothing in a way. Saturn in the 10th house people, I kind of mentioned how earlier with Saturn in the 6th house people, I would say that maybe you grew up struggling with money, and I think that because of this, you have a strong need to be a workaholic. You have a strong need to kind of overly succeed, go out of your way to really just make a point of accomplishing everything that you set out to do. I think that you have a fear of failure, and I think this stems from the fact that you like to always have kind of means to take care of people and take care of yourself. However, I do think this need to like always provide is also kind of driven by some fear of lack of someone being able to provide for you at an early age. And I think because of this, you can become a very severe workaholic. And I think the biggest lesson for Saturn in 10th is to find, again, balance between work and home. I'm saying again because I said the same thing for Saturn in 6th house. And then Saturn in 11th house, your biggest difficulties in life is feeling understood, especially around groups of people, friendships. You take your friendships very seriously in a world and a society where people just don't take commitments and relationships and bonds and people that seriously. So you'll be very loyal and committed and faithful to people right off the bat. You'll give people 100% when people are giving you 50. And I think because of this, you can be very jaded. I think you want to isolate yourself a lot. I think you feel uneasy with big groups of people. You probably don't like to go hang out with like a big group of people, or the idea of like joining a frat or sorority in college was probably or would probably be very scary for you, just because you don't feel comfortable. You like maybe have one or two close friends for life, and that's like your comfort level. That's what makes you feel good. But I feel like a big crowd, big groups of people that act like they're friends with everyone but don't really know anyone, I feel that those are just things that you don't understand, you don't try to understand. That's just not who you are. Saturn and 11th house people feel like loners in life, but I feel like they're also just very loyal and faithful people in a world where a lot of people just aren't. So that's my hot take with that. For Saturn and 12th house people, kind of similarly to Saturn and 11th house people, this is the house of hidden enemies. Kind of going through life feeling like everyone is out to get you. I feel like there's some weird suspicion or this hyper awareness about people's motives or people's feelings. I think you're very empathetic, so you can pick up on things very easily, but this can also make you incredibly skeptical and suspicious, and you're always kind of looking over your shoulder because I feel like it's almost like you know too much all at once and it's overwhelming for you. So you can be very isolating in life at times. You can feel like a loner at times. And I think it's just because you have a tendency to assume everyone's a hidden enemy when they're not, and then self-sabotage because of that. I think it's important to kind of like, when you're trying to learn who people are and if you can trust them, learning how to give them a bit of trust. I feel like you always feel written off in life too, and you don't feel like people trust you that easily, but then you sometimes don't give people the same chance. Okay, well that was my very like brief rundown of all the Saturn signs. I did write a whole threads about this on Twitter. I have lots of content about this on my Patreon, so if you want more, if you feel like this didn't cover it for you and maybe you're more interested now because of this, please check it out, consider supporting me, and I will see you in my next video.